the Olympics for us then. It's an absolute joy to be at this game. They play it on the last day. This much talked about, much admired US team taking on Spain, and history squarely against the Spanish, it has to be said.
Well, this is, I've been very fortunate. This is my eighth Olympics calling basketball, and I've seen the United States lose some of these games. So they still have to play the game. Spain coming at them with Pau Gasol and Marc Gasol, the brothers. Jose Calderon, Rudy Fernandez, Juan Carlos Navarro. This is his fourth Olympics. So they've got some very experienced players that can heat up. But can they withstand four quarters of the United States offensive attack?
I think the historical perspective is good to throw in. The USA has participated in 16 Olympic Games in basketball since 1936. They only missed Moscow, of course, in 1980. They've won 13. Silver in Munich, bronze in 88 and 04. So, on the other side of the ledger, Pau Gasol, who you've mentioned, top point scorer in the Olympics, 04 and 08. And Spain have earned their place in this final. They've battled their way to get there. And they are going to make the most of this stage and this opportunity.
Well, if you're a fan of Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory, this is the golden ticket to get into this game today. And people are coming in all styles and flags of many, many countries here. The bronze medal game played earlier. Russia upset Argentina to win the bronze medal, 81-77. 23-year-old Alexei Shved had an outstanding game, ushering in the new Russians. 23 years old, 25 points, and the oldest player on that team, Andrei Kirilenko, 20 points in what was probably his final Olympics. One thing about the U.S. team, Steve, is this is not as old as most of their opponents. There's only one player 30 or over, and that's Kobe Bryant, who's 33. Everybody else in their 20s and one teenager.
A little frightening to think that Dwayne Wade, Chris Bosh, Derrick Rose, and Dwight Howard are not here. You know, you can only speculate about what difference their presence might have made, but I don't think you could say it would have been a weaker team if they had been here.
Well, you wouldn't have had a 19-year-old playing for the U.S. Anthony Davis had Dwight Howard, Superman, been able to be. Dwight Howard, by the way, traded the other day to the Los Angeles Lakers. And Kobe Bryant was having kind of a slow game in the semifinal. And at halftime, he came out just all fired up, and we didn't know what the coach might have said to him. Well, he found out at halftime that Dwight Howard had been traded to the Lakers, and it was now his teammate. And he got all fired up and came out and hit shot after shot after shot.
Just one little reminder of history, too. When the United States lost one Olympic final in this event, 51-50 to the Soviet Union in 1972. That was the closest ever points difference in a men's basketball final.
And if you remember that game, the United States won, then they did it over, the United States won, then they did it over again, and the Soviet Union won. And then they said that's the end of the game. So that was much disputed, and it's good to have some controversy now and then, some memories to talk about. You and I were sitting together in Barcelona, Spain, watching the original Dream Team play. And there's been some talk of whether this team was as good as that. I don't think you can compare the two. It's a different generation. And there were 11 players from that team went on to the Hall of Fame. Introductions for Spain. Number four is Pau Gasol. Rudy Fernandez. Number five, Sergio Rodriguez. Number six, Juan Carlos Navarro. Number seven, Jose Calderon now. Number eight, Felipe Reyes. Number nine, Victor Claver, a new Portland Trailblazer ad. He's number 10. Fernando Sanemeterio, number 11. 12 will be Serge Yule. He's a good outside shooter. Little brother Marc Gasol plays for the Memphis Grizzlies, and there are no Grizzlies in Tennessee, so it's an interesting name of the team. He's number 13. Serge Ibaka, Air Congo, plays for the Oklahoma City Thunder. He comes off the bench, number 14. And Victor Sada, number 15. Their coach, Sergio Scariolo, and he's a good one. He's been with them in international basketball for quite some time.
Five from the USA team returning from Beijing, six for Spain.
And this is their one true center. Tyson Chandler gets only about 8 minutes a game, followed by Kevin Durant, who is a deadly outside shooter. LeBron James, King James, number six. Russell Westbrook, quick little guard, number seven. Deron Williams, number eight. Andre Iguodala found out he was traded at halftime of the last game he played. Kobe Bryant, one of the most famous basketball players in the world, number 10. Kevin Love will tell you about his family lineage. It's quite interesting, wearing number 11. James Harden, fear the beard, they say. Chris Paul, great passer, point guard, starting point guard, number 13. Anthony Davis, the 19-year-old, and then Carmelo Anthony, who got hotter than any player has ever got. We'll tell you a little bit later, but now the national anthems. First Spain. The national anthem of Spain.
Anthem of the United States of America.
Are the national anthems of the two teams, and they'll give each other some little gifts, and then they'll get down to business. This United States team, very explosive, scored a record 156 points earlier in a game against Nigeria.
Bruce, you've been watching a lot more of the U.S. than I have, and their shooting from outside has been nothing less than extraordinary during this tournament. Can you explain why that's been happening?
They have great shooters. Actually, they're very streaky. And if they get on a roll, what the United States does is they keep feeding the shooter the ball. So let's say Kobe Bryant makes two. They're going to look for him the next several times down court. Kevin Durant, also a great outside shooter. But nobody in Olympic history ever got hotter than Carmelo Anthony on that night against Nigeria. In 7 minutes, he scored 35 points, 11 three-pointers.
That doesn't make sense. It's just going to be a great show. And even watching the USA team come onto the court for their introductions, they turn that into a performance. And I can't wait to see what happens here. And I'm hoping that Spain play a really lively role in this.
As you can see, they lost to Russia and they lost to Brazil. Brazil, a very talented team. Russia, the bronze medalist. United States, look at that big number against Nigeria. But against Argentina, against Australia, still 126, 119 points against some very talented teams. Nobody on either of these teams has any scoring records in the all-time books. That belongs to the great Brazilian Oscar Schmidt. In five Olympics, he scored 1,093 points. Second behind that would be Andrew Gaze of Australia with 789. But Oscar Schmidt, I remember watching him in Seoul. He averaged 42 points a game, 55 in one game. And he would walk across the half court and throw up a shot. He was just something else. He was a freak of nature. Here's a starting lineup for Spain. You've got the Gasol brothers, Rudy Fernandez. Four Olympics for Juan Carlos Navarro and Jose Calderon, another veteran. A lot of NBA talent on both sides here for Spain and for the United States. And we'll have to see if Sergio Scariolo has anything in store for this lineup for the U.S. Again, Tyson Chandler will play about 4 minutes before he will rotate out. And then you've got shooters all over the court. LeBron James, the strongest player. And then on the wings, you've got Kevin Durant on one side, you've got Kobe Bryant on the other, and you have to pick your poison defensively.
They're absolutely prolific in possession, the United States, but their defense is rather like a tap. You know, they turn it on when they need to. As long as they're outscoring the opposition, that's a priority. But if they need to step up the defense, then they can do that. So we'll just see how this game unfolds.
And it's been typical of these games that they're reasonably close at the half. The officials for this, the referee, Cristiano Morano of Brazil, Michael Allen of Australia, and Mr. Christodoulou from Greece.
And what an honor for these officials to be involved in this game. The gold medal basketball game, Spain should not be intimidated. Many of their players have been here before. They know what to expect. Lots of experience and ready to take it to the U.S. if they possibly can.
I think one of the keys to the game is what kind of defense Spain can bring to try to slow the pace of the game. Spain's averaging 78 points a game. The United States averaging 118 points per game. So if there's anything like the past games, it's really going to be up to Spain to try to throw a big blanket over the U.S. offense.
Spain can be streaky. First quarter against Russia in a preliminary game, 28-11. And then they went on to lose that game. But put four quarters like that together, and you got something special going on.
They were the silver medalists in 2008 in Beijing, so they played a great game against each other just 4 years ago. Let's see if we can get another great game tonight. Players very familiar with each other. Starters for Spain, Pau Gasol, Marc Gasol, Jose Calderon, Rudy Fernandez, Juan Carlos Navarro for the United States, Kevin Durant, LeBron James, Kobe Bryant, Chris Paul, and Tyson Chandler will jump center.
Well, there's a lot of mutual respect on the court, but they're about to go into war. Just watch the flash bulbs go off here. Some of the corporate seats not filled, always a shame, but I think in a few minutes they will be.
They're still drinking some champagne upstairs.
Yes.
But Tyson Chandler to jump center against Pau Gasol. And we're underway from North Greenwich Arena. The gold medal game, the United States in the white, Spain in the orangish red. Rather unique color for Spain. Kobe Bryant. He loves to shoot, but this time he passes. An easy one for Tyson Chandler. Nice assist to Bryant. Chris Paul pressuring on defense. Pau Gasol kicks it back out. Navarro for three and the foul. Juan Carlos Navarro, who didn't play the first two games of the Olympics due to a back injury, gets the assist and a chance for a very rare four-point play. And again, his fourth Olympics.
Well, it's that kind of experience that Spain's going to have to draw on and rely on. And that's a fine start for them. You don't want to be blown away, you know, 10 or 12 zip in the first couple of minutes and really feel like you're not in the contest.
Kevin Durant quickly answers for the U.S. That's one of the two bookend outside shooters. They have Kobe Bryant on one side, Durant on the other side, waiting on the wing. LeBron James, very strong in the middle. So offensively, the United States, very hard to stop. Rudy Fernandez is number five. He's the other guard for Spain. Jose Calderon inbound. Calderon running the point. That's Pau Gasol. Likes to pass back and forth with his brother. Takes the little hook shot. So the Los Angeles Laker in his third Olympics gets off to a good start. He's a three-time NBA All-Star. Chris Paul, better known for his passing than his scoring. Kevin Durant inside. LeBron James switches hands, misses the little shot to the left, gets his own rebound. And an offensive rebound for the United States. Score it. Spain's got to do a great job of blocking out, and they couldn't do it that time.
Yeah, a little bit soft on the rebound, Spain. That's the way they're going to have to be tough.
Foul on Marc Gasol. So Kevin Durant, who missed the shot, followed him. And he's got five already. We've seen a lot of missed free throws over this Olympic Games. These rims are double the size, double the thickness. Not very forgiving. Marc Gasol has it stripped away. They're still fighting for it, and jump ball, and it will still be possession Spain.
Nothing between the teams in their free throw percentage across the tournament. 71% the U.S., 72% for Spain.
I think Mark looking for a tooth here. A lot of action inside that huddle. Looked like a rugby scrum.
That would be a maul if they've got their hands on it.
Gasol can't get it. And Chris Paul crosses the timeline for the U.S. Very quick. And Paul got a little bit out of control with that basketball. Luckily for him, Chandler was there, but he couldn't make the shot. Navarro. Another three-point basket for La Bamba. Seven for Juan Carlos Navarro. Spain leads by two. Back comes Durant, and we've got a foul away from the basketball as players tumble to the ground.
Tyson Chandler there landing on top of Rudy Fernandez.
Fernandez getting the worst of it and the foul. The stars have come out for this game. Sergio Scariolo. We haven't talked much about the coach of this U.S. team, trying to coach his second gold medal, the winningest college coach in United States history, Mike Krzyzewski. Durant, he'll shoot from anywhere. That's two in a row he's missed. Navarro off the screen.
And again.
Still hot? No. But nice offensive board by Pau Gasol. Another one for Gasol. And Navarro again.
This time. Spain making a little bit of an early statement.
And the men wearing dresses are here in force. Gotta love the Spanish crowd. 5-point lead for Spain. A lot of chanting and singing going on here. That's Kobe Bryant.
Well, he's done ever so well to shoot over that defense. It was right in his face.
Navarro, he's on fire. Fernandez for three. And LeBron James comes away with it. Sneaking down, beating the defense. And Durant and his shot rejected out of bounds. Fernandez made sure that didn't go in.
The official stepping in very quickly here after.
And it was a must foul, and he reached over to get him, and then a nice follow by Fernandez. He takes issue with how hard that foul was, and Fernandez could have blocked that with any part of his arm. Calderon with the foul. And it looks like they're going to call a flagrant foul. So Duran will get the free throws, and the United States will get the ball. We've got our first substitution.
I think that's fair. That looked bad.
Carmelo Anthony, another scorer, comes in for the United States, replacing Chandler. So Duran missed his only free throw. Back to the line. Amazing intensity level already in this game, Steve.
Well, do you see any future in Spain trying to unsettle physically this big, strong U.S. side?
Absolutely. They have to play a very physical game. They can't give up easy jump shots from the wing. Spain now in a zone defense. 2-3. Two guards out front. Three defenders down low that asked for three-pointers to be shot against you, and Kobe Bryant obliges them.
Not the kind of guy who needs a second invitation. 6 points for Kobe.
Two in a row for Bryant, so look for him to ask for the basketball next time down court. Mark Gasol, cross. Navarro again.
Tough shot.
He's got a dozen points already, and we haven't even played half of the first quarter. Anthony. Carmelo Anthony, three-pointer. We had 21 U.S. three-pointers in the last game. And a foul on Anthony, working a little bit overzealous against Marc Gasol. There's that pass outside, and Anthony, known for these bombs.
A really high arc on those shots, doesn't he?
Spain led by 5 points just like a blink of the eye ago. They're now down by four. Marc Gasol, turn around. Two-point game for the gold medal. First quarter, North Greenwich Arena. I'm Bruce Breslow, and with me, as always, Steve Rebilliard. And a blocking foul, and Duran will go back to the line. The crowd does not like that call. Neither does Mrs. Gasol.
I think there'll be quite a few neutrals in the crowd looking for a big underdog effort to hear from Spain. But then there's a whole chunk of people just delighted to be in the company of this U.S. team.
Well, don't knight them or anything.
Nevertheless,
that's
in the company.
That's two on Marc Gasol.
Nevertheless, in the company of greatness.
Thank you. So 9 points now for Duran. There's the beard on the bench. He will come in later. James Harden. A lot more intensity from the United States than they usually bring in the first quarter. Stolen away, LeBron James. They're going to look for the shooters. And they've got a lot of them on the court. Anthony.
So Rudy Fernandez, they're moving in, trying to sweep that ball away from the rim as they're allowed to, and a different kind of goaltending rules here as opposed to the NBA.
And yes, International Olympic basketball. Once the ball is above the rim, it has hit the rim, it's free game. You can pluck it out. Anthony again from miles away. And Spain's playing an excellent game, and they're already down 25-16. It's a relentless offensive attack. United States hitting 62% of its shots, but 71% from beyond the arc. 5 of 7 three-pointers. Spain, Not bad at all. 3 of 5, 60% from beyond the arc.
Shooting 55% from the field, Spain, and they're down by plenty.
Sergio Rodriguez now in for Spain, number 6. Navarro, he has been the hot hand. Juan Carlos again. This time he can't get it to fall. James getting a bit fancy. Durant. And Serge Ibaka now in with the bright green tennis shoes. And Air Congo can't make it. One of the few players from the Congo here at the Olympics playing, well, the only one playing for Spain.
True. And the foul eventually on Pau Gasol.
So Pau to the free throw line. First foul on James. LeBron James, the most valuable player multiple times in the NBA, won his first NBA championship this past year. Pau Gasol knows something about that. Bunch of championships with the Los Angeles Lakers, his third Olympics. Both Mark and Pau's parents both played basketball. Must have been a lot of food served at that table. They're both 215 centimeters, 7'1".
Rather feed them for a day than a week.
Carmelo Anthony from the corner. And it's Kevin Love in, and that's his specialty, offensive rebounds for the United States. Kevin Love from a basketball family and a famous family. I'll tell you a little bit more about that in a little bit. And Rudy Fernandez comes away for Spain. They need a spark on offense and a foul on Ron Williams.
Well, Spain does like to run and gun and just trying to halt the momentum here.
Well, they've got to score a lot of points in this game, and Navarro's really putting it all out there at age 33. He was doubtful to even play in the last game, and his back has gotten better in a hurry. He'd been out for quite some time due to injury. There's a look at the U.S. coach, Mike Krzyzewski, and then Sergio Scariolo on the other side. And what a start for Juan Carlos.
Spain have only scored more than 90 points once. That was in the game against China, 97-81. And there are five occasions the U.S. has scored more than 100.
And Williams from outside. And count that as a three-pointer as well. I thought his foot might have been on the line, but the referee says no. And he's a lot closer to the court than you and I. Rodriguez working on Love. There's a mismatch somewhere on the court. Fernandez for three. And Ibaka with the rebound and a whistle. So Serge working really hard down low, trying to give Spain some firepower. You can see those shoes from West London.
There's been a few of them on the track.
Foul on Kevin Love. His father, Stan Love, played in the NBA for many years, and his uncle is the lead singer of the Beach Boys, Mike Love.
We made a commitment pre-game we'd make no Beach Boy puns. We'll try and stand by that. I'm sure they've all been done. Bruce is trying to think of one now.
No, just some good vibrations between the two teams. No, we can't go there. Ibaka will get one more. Looking for his first point. One of three players from the Oklahoma City Thunder on the court. Actually, there's four. Three on the United States and Ibaka. They finished runner-up in the most recent NBA championship. James has been quiet offensively. They haven't needed him on offense. Williams, no look, pass to Love.
And that's what this crowd came to see.
All you need is love. How about that? A Beatles cross-reference to the Beach Boys. We've got a timeout on the court. United States out in front, 30-21.
I was warned that line might come, and I still managed to smile at it. But
love getting up. He came out here about an hour and a half before tip-off and shot three-pointers for about a half hour just to be ready for that dunk shot.
I was watching him in the warm-up from the corner, and he just could not sink one. So he gave up, ambled in, and just dunked one because he was sick of missing.
Spain came out red hot, led by Juan Carlos Navarro. He has 14 points. Pau Gasol with four, Mark Gasol with a bucket, and Serge Ibaka with a point for the United States. Durant has nine, Anthony off the bench with eight. Kobe Bryant, a couple three-pointers for six, and a couple other players have shared the scoring column. James here looking to pass. And there is no range, outside range limit on some of these shooters, is there?
We'd like to bring you audio from the U.S. huddle, but that's not going to happen. They're not keen on that.
Well, they got caught with a live microphone in Beijing, and there's no microphones in the huddle this time. Fernandez. Sergio Rodriguez now. Off a screen from Gasol. Ibaka, and he is fouled going up. A lot easier to dunk if you still have the ball in your hand.
Well, they're busy setting screens, Spain, trying to get the offense going here. And he was hit from behind pretty solidly by Deron Williams.
That's two fouls on Williams.
That's an innocent face. Could not have been him, and it was.
Ibaka, one out of two so far from the line. That's our sky camera. We have a little mini blimp going around the inside.
It's actually on cables, folks. There's only some things that Bruce tells you you need to believe. That wasn't one of them.
There could be a mini blimp.
There could.
A drone camera.
Ibaka.
He's got three now, all of them from the free throw line. Minute 28 left to go in the first quarter. High scoring quarter, as you might expect. Westbrook into the lineup for the United States and quickly gets in the scoring column. Russell Westbrook, another one of those players from Oklahoma City, along with Durant and James Harden and Ibaka. So Pau Gasol now with 6 points. They've got to match the United States, not only basket for basket, but they need some stops. Touch pass into the corner for Durant. Three more.
Well, that was sweet. Through the hands. Very slick. Great understanding.
And Carmelo Anthony with a rare assist. Great ball movement. There's a lot of egos on this team, and they've really set them aside working as a team. 10-point lead for the United States. Navarro out top. Rodriguez now. Nine on the shot clock. Alley-oop.
Oh, yes, sir. Well, you might have expected to see that first from the U.S.
And Rudy Fernandez came flying out the backside. Chris Paul, the U.S. will work for the last shot. 17 seconds left in the quarter. Paul's shot will not go. Ibaka, a nice rebound. 5 seconds still left in the quarter. So Spain will get just under four clicks to get a shot off. Gasol has a shot blocked at the buzzer by Durant. What a first quarter.
And there's the endeavor in defense. Durant, you know, he's going to rack up a big total of points here, but he's made an important little hand on the ball at the death.
And here's one last shot at that block. You could have just gone into the locker room hoping he didn't make it, but a good defensive effort in the United States. 35, Spain 27 in a quest for a gold medal.
Well, the U.S. 7 from 10 with their three-point attempts. 3 from 7, Spain, both very respectable. But 70%, my goodness, you'd take that. And they're still lighting it up from outside. And they've got all these options, Bruce, that if someone hasn't got a hot hand, someone else will have. And I like the importance where you say you put the ego to one side and you concentrate on doing the simple things well, whether it's the touch pass or whether it's the defensive effort from Durant in the last second. Egos don't matter when you're doing those things.
And Navarro, what an effort he gave them. First quarter, 14 points for the KG veteran, 33 years old, playing with a bad back in his fourth Olympics. But the one thing that we needed to see from Spain has not appeared yet, and that's good defense. They've been unable to match up, unable to put a hand in the face of the shooters of the U.S., and they've really got to make more of an effort on the defensive end.
Well, they give up 35 points a quarter. They're going to be on the end of 140 by match end. So it's got to step up, and now.
Navarro leads all scorers with those 14 points. That's Carmelo Anthony. And we're underway. This is the second quarter, gold medal match. USA in the white, Spain in the red. Love to Durant. He's got Anthony. And he will take it himself. He's put up quite a few shots in this game already. 3 of 8. And that's Rudy Fernandez. He can get as hot as anybody.
Spain needed to be first to score in the second quarter.
Reach-in foul called on Sergio Rodriguez. And no defense played by the United States that time down court either. Spain within 5. U.S. with the ball. Westbrook. And good defense played, and he had nowhere to go but to throw it away. And Fernandez loses it. Last touch by the U.S. For Rudy Fernandez, just 27 years old, plays for the Denver Nuggets. His sister Marta represented Spain in basketball. Another foul away from the basket. That's the second foul on Carmelo Anthony.
Spain have won a lot of important titles, Bruce. It's just this one that is toughest to win for them. World champions in 2006, European champions twice in the last few years, 09 and 11.
You know, one thing the United States has not had any success with here is getting the ball inside. They are living and dying on that three-point shot. Navarro. That's Pau Gasol over Love. Nice strong move to the hoop. LeBron James into the corner. Durant will keep shooting as long as you give him the ball.
Well, U.S. made a mess of that rebound. Four hands on it, and they came up empty.
And you can hear the crowd squarely behind Spain, the underdog. Rodriguez fouled here. Chris Paul dogging him as he goes to the basket, and Paul reaches in. And that's two fouls on Chris Paul.
And Spain have just found a little more intensity in this second quarter. Down by 8 at the break.
So they're playing much better defense. U.S. forced to take those long three-pointers, and when you start missing them, other teams can catch up in a hurry. It's So Rodriguez will get another.
USA has not yet scored in this quarter.
7-0 run for Spain. Kobe Bryant. Good defense by Navarro. And they say maybe a little bit too close, but come on. That was a mono duel there. You can't call a foul in the middle of that.
Well, it's pretty soft.
We wanted to know what was going to happen at the end of that. James! Arnold Schwarzenegger with the mayor of London.
Boris Johnson. Well, there's a pair.
Rudy Fernandez gets it in. That's Mark Gasol. What a shot.
I'm trying to imagine the basketball conversation between Arnie Schwarzenegger and Boris Johnson, and I don't know where it would go.
It's a one-point game, folks. 37-36. We're in the second quarter. And Spain can take the lead on this possession. That last shot by Mark Gasol over the center for the U.S. Tyson Chandler was very impressive.
LeBron James waiting until a minute and a half into the second quarter to score his first points.
Well, he announced his revival, or his arrival rather loudly, didn't he?
Ostentatious.
Rodriguez to the hoop, dishes off, and Ibaka thinks better of taking that shot. Rodriguez for three.
And a good decision by Ibaka to kick it outside.
And Spain takes the lead. And tempers flare and a flagrant foul called on the United States center Tyson Chandler, who lost his control.
Spain leading.
And there's no need for that.
Spain leading this quarter 12-2. It's what this game needed, Bruce. We need Spain to stay in it to get us a great gold medal game.
That's what happened. Calderon bumped chest with Tyson Chandler, puts his finger in his face, punch, gives him a little poke in the face. So both back and forth, both sides. So they called a foul on each of them. So the U.S. will inbound the ball. So the fouls negate each other. Technical foul called on each. You wondered if they were going to try to be physical with the United States. That should give you an answer. Kobe Bryant, he will shoot. And Love is there for the rebound. And Scariolo just puts his hands over his eyes. He does not like to see those easy baskets. Navarro kicks it out, stolen by the U.S.
Oh,
and a missed layup by Durant. Gets his own shot back, and he's fouled. And Durant's having a tough go. He's missed his last five shots.
Just couldn't sprint free of the defense to create a little showtime.
He also could have passed the ball quite easily. He won the NBA Rookie of the Year when he was only 18 years old. 23-year-old scorer. He's had an off shooting night and already has 13.
US 5 from 7, free throw line.
Rodriguez kicks it out to the corner. That's Yule for three, and the foul off the bench. Sergio Yule gives him a little spark every game.
He brings something to the court. There's a Sergio.
That foul was away from the ball, so Spain will inbound and a chance for a five-point play. And they turn it over.
Well, misunderstanding there between Rodriguez and Ibaka.
James to the basket. And good defense, but a foul. Ibaka wasn't going to give him that one for free. James, very hard to match up with. If anybody comes close, it's Ibaka. Great defensive player. Both of his parents played for the Congo. James has been about that big since seventh grade. He is a freakish physical specimen. His high school games were televised. No one ever televises high school games. James was part of the team that lost two Olympics ago in Athens, so there is that fresh memory. Mark Gasol, pushed from behind, doesn't get the call, but makes the basket.
Turns around, look at the officials, asks for it, and signals the push, not given.
And Mike Krzyzewski wants a timeout. As you take a look at that one, as he shoved a little bit from behind, makes the basket. And Spain out in front of the United States, midway through the second quarter, 44-43.
It was no more than a love tap, just a little push in the small of the back. You make the appeal and see what happens, but the officials weren't buying into it. And Mike Krzyzewski has
a little... Try to get Krzyzewski out of that spelling.
Well, he's been around long enough for us to know how to pronounce it.
He's one of the great teachers of the game of basketball. Became the winningest all-time college coach about a year ago. Scariolo's got to be pleased. Spain really stepped up the defense, and the United States, which was having a monstrous shooting percentage early, has cooled off. The U.S. 2 of 6 in this quarter. Spain 6 of 6, perfect. There's a look at their captain, Juan Carlos Navarro. And Kobe Bryant, the U.S. does not have a captain. They elected to be captainless.
I don't think they're rudderless.
If they lose, there's nobody to go down with the ship. Chris Paul, the point guard for the U.S. with it. 6:17 left to go. We're only in the second quarter. This could be a final score with some of the games we've seen with some of these teams. But the offense is very strong here. Durant. And Durant scores the basket and draws the foul. Thought that could have gone either way.
Strong move from Kevin.
James with the assist. And he went by Yule like he wasn't even there.
Yule just didn't get to him in time. Too quick. USA back in front by the 2.
7 consecutive free throws by Kevin Durant. Sergio Garcia to Pau Gasol. Working on Love. Gasol shoots. Comes up empty. And James is starting to get in the flow of things here for the U.S., making some things happen. Durant still hasn't hit that outside shot, but how many shots can you put up in a half of a basketball game? La Bamba! And is that an offensive foul or offensive goaltending on Mark Gasol? I couldn't tell. No, that's not only a foul, that's his 4th foul. And he is very upset with that call. And so is his coach, and everybody here dressed up in the colors and flags of Spain.
U.S. by a couple. They're led by 8 at quarter time. Spain have done what they've needed to make a game of this in the second. But call going against them. Just the Giants gone a little cold in the last 60 seconds. And the USA threatening to dominate the second half of the second quarter.
So all that extra shooting practice pays off for Kevin Love. But with 4 fouls, that really puts Spain in a hole. High scoring contest, as you might expect. Navarro. And an offensive foul, I think, will be called on Kobe Bryant. Let's see. That's 2 on Bryant. Durant's put up 12 shots already, made 4. Your arm's got to get tired after a while.
That's just turned into a little bit of an arm wrestle here, Bruce. The scoring's dried up. That's the next couple of minutes. See who emerges from this kind of period of the doldrums and gets on with it. The rhythm's gone from the game.
You can't have perfect shooting the whole game if you're Spain. Navarro had those last 2 go in and out. That's 5 rebounds for Kevin Love already, and he drew the foul with good position that time. Felipe Reyes called for the foul. And Kobe Bryant's going to get a rest. Some how tough the action is inside here. We've got cameras coming at you from all angles.
Some of them even have camera people behind them. But there's quite a few on cranes and racks and cables.
United States 12 out of 13 from the free throw line. And after making those, Love will sit. Carmelo Anthony, another outside shooter, comes in. Williams in at guard along with Westbrook. Gasol gets it down low. Double teamed immediately, but a beautiful pass slapped away by Durant. And guess who? Juan Carlos is back. 17 for Navarro. And you're right, Steve, the United States has been out of sync for a while. And an offensive foul on LeBron James.
They've gone cold in a few areas. 7 from 14 from outside now at 50%. Spain, 7 from 12, 58.
I've seen some great shooting on both sides. Spain's made 10 of 11 from the line.
I wouldn't say 50% from outside is poor. It's just come back a little.
So Rudy Fernandez hits his first. And every time the United States creates some separation, back comes Spain. Williams. James. Looking for somebody to take the shot. James will take it himself.
Just climbs over the defense.
Four minutes still to play in the second quarter. Had a moment to breathe. As the pace has noticeably slowed down. Good thing for the referees because they were exhausted running up and down the court. Oh, that was pretty good defense being played by Navarro, and a very quick whistle, and the crowd doesn't like it at all.
Neither does Navarro. He thought he got this clean. The arm did come around the waist but, you know, marginal. Westbrook.
Russell Westbrook to the free throw line. 23 years old.
Parts of the crowd cheer the miss.
3:35 to go in this first half. Gold medal on the line. United States up by four. Expected a close first half. Most of the games against their opponents have been close in the first half. The United States usually creates separation toward the second half of the third quarter. Let's see if that rings true here. Westbrook loses it out of bounds off his own knee, and Spain will get it. The United States is a much better team with Chris Paul at point guard. He really settles everybody down.
Shots to the Russian team, who picked up a bronze medal in what was a great playoff for third and fourth with Argentina. They led for most of the match, got caught in the last quarter and held on.
And an offensive foul call. An elbow was thrown by Felipe Reyes. And the crowd getting a little bit louder and louder with each of these calls. Referee called that from all the way across the court. He saw the elbow come up. 3 minutes left to go in the second quarter. Anthony from outside can't find the range. James with the offensive putback.
The U.S. just cannot buy a shot from outside in this second quarter. They're 0-for-5, having shot 7 from 10 in the first quarter. Massive turnaround in their outside success.
James gets the steal ahead to Williams. James calls for the ball. 13 on the shot clock. Shot clock hadn't been much of a factor in this game, has it? James takes it. And good defense by Pau Gasol. Navarro comes back the other way. Navarro! The one-man wrecking crew for Spain. Williams for three.
Finally.
It's been a while since the United States hit one of those. They were red hot to start the game and then cooled off. Or Kevin Durant cooled off.
1-for-6 from outside. In this quarter.
That's the first personal foul called on Durant. James did a good job inside. A lot of his points came on rebounds. Sits down with 8 points, 6 rebounds, and 3 assists already. And a quiet game. Rudy Fernandez back to the free throw line where he has been flawless.
There's a lot of pressure on the officials in this game as we get close to halftime.
And the U.S. coach is very upset. They're saying that he shouldn't be the one shooting the free throws, that it was a different player foul. And an offensive rebound for Spain. Minute 30 left to go on this first half. What a great first half in this gold medal game. Fernandez, and he's fouled. I think that's 3 already on Williams.
Getting a sense the U.S. defense is a little angry here. And just stepped it up to another level again.
And he's going to have to come out of the game with those three fouls. He'll be replaced by Chris Paul, the starting point guard, who has two fouls. So back to the line, Rudy Fernandez again. Very silky, smooth shooter. Plays for the Denver Nuggets.
Spain lead the quarter 27-23 and only trail by four.
Well, at this pace, Spain will easily eclipse 100 points as well. Williams hit his last one and gets nothing, but Love is there again. Relentless rebounder. Three offensive rebounds, six for the game for Love in limited playing time. Played only 6 minutes.
Felipe Reyes was all over him.
So third foul on Felipe Reyes, so a lot of fouls adding up. The United States can go very deep on their bench. Spain can go about eight players deep. Love's made all five he's attempted from the charity stripe. Of course, I would curse him by saying that. 1 minute to go here. First half. Playing for the gold medal, the United States leading Spain by five.
Spain must finish off this quarter, Bruce. They've done a great job.
Gasol over Love. Comes up a bit short. Anthony goes for the rebound, and Ibaka fouls him from behind. No, they give the foul to Anthony. Watch Anthony and Ibaka fighting for the ball, and Anthony is holding, so that was a great call by the official. Three fouls on Anthony. And we've got a quick timeout. 43 ticks left on the clock in this first half, and Steve, it's been a game of runs for both teams.
Yeah, I was just watching Carmelo Anthony, even before the game started, he's attributed that last foul. It seems to be a guy who marches to his own drum. As the anthem's being played, he's just kind of shuffling around, hands in the pockets. And he's his own man. If he steps up in the second half. He's been kept a bit quiet just in the last quarter.
It's been said that the only regret Carmelo Anthony has is that he never got to watch himself play. So he does march to his own drum.
We have one or two athletes at home who famously said they've never read a book that they didn't write.
There's that alley-oop earlier. Rudy Fernandez flashing in. Well, Carmelo Anthony's a great player. Now with the New York Knickerbockers after years in Denver. Seems like he's been in the game forever. And he's still in his 20s. Leading scorers. Durant with 17 for the U.S. Navarro, 19 points for Spain. And Ibaka will go to the line. A lot of fouls. 16 already for each team in the first half. He's made his last three from the line after missing his first. Spain's hit 16 of 18 free throws. The United States 15 of 18. Couldn't ask for a better gold medal game than this. ...43 seconds left to go in the first half. U.S. up by three. Paul takes it himself for three. Very quick shot that time.
Oh,
that way, well, that way they're insured of at least two possessions on offense with the 24-second shot clock. That's probably why he did it. Pau Gasol backing in against Love. Ibaka goes strong for the rebound, torn away by Williams. And that's Iguodala. He's had an interesting week. He was traded at halftime of the last game. And an intentional foul call
on Iguodala.
He started the semifinal game as a member of Philadelphia and finished it as a member of the Denver Nuggets.
Did he have anything to do with it?
Maybe his agent. So this is a big finish here with 3 seconds to go for Spain. Seven consecutive free throws for Rudy Fernandez, and Spain will get the ball back with a chance to take the lead with 3 seconds left on that intentional foul.
Wonder what Sergio Scariolo has in mind, 51-year-old coach who coached a lot in Moscow.
Well, I just love the fact that Spain scored 58 points in the first half already. Yeah. They've outscored the United States in the quarter 31-24. Getting loud in here as Sergio Scariolo outlines what he wants here with 3 seconds to go. He's got a lot of scores. And if I were Coach Krzyzewski, I would be talking about do not foul.
Situation just getting a little serious for the U.S. They have been blowing some teams out of the water in the second half when they crank it up.
Makes for a much better game, though, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah.
A lot more intensity. You'll see more defense in the second half, and you've seen a lot of intensity there. There's that intentional foul on Iguodala.
The game could have been over by now if the U.S. carried on where they left off after a 35-27 first quarter, but Spain had seriously different ideas, and their only way of staying with the U.S. is to be physical. If they just watch each other play, they're going to get outscored every time by this team.
They're in some serious foul trouble, though. We'll talk about that when we begin the second half. But first, the last seconds, they get a shot off Navarro. And no, they won't. But it's a great half of basketball and a one-point differential. The United States and Spain locking horns for the gold medal. 59-58 are scored halftime. ...31-24 in the second quarter for Spain, Steve.
Well, if you lose the first quarter by 8, but you win the second quarter by 7, you've given yourself reason to believe if they can keep their key players on the court in the second half, which might be an issue for them, then they can really put the U.S. under pressure, and under pressure they haven't really been.
Mark Gasol has 4 fouls, Reyes with 3 fouls, and Rodriguez for 3 fouls for Spain. For the United States, they've got some foul trouble to worry about as well. Carmelo Anthony has 3 fouls. Williams has 3. And there's 4 players with 2 fouls for the U.S. So a lot of free throw shooting in that first half. It broke up what was a very fluid open. But this is how it stands. 59-58. We'll be back with the second half in just a few minutes.
Chicken Skittles! you that they are human. Give them another round of applause.
Absolutely.
The Get Tricky Skippers!
Yes!
Wonderful stuff.
What I'm talking about.
Wonderful stuff.
Look at his firm hands, his skipping hands.
Nick, right, we've got Nick here from Get Tricky Skippers. I never get tired of seeing that. You know what? Introduce some of the players, some of the jumpers from here, and tell us where they come from, because they really are a global crew, aren't they?
Well, we got five from the US.
Hold up! Five from the USA! Anybody here from the USA?
We got three from Belgium.
Three from Belgium! Anybody here from Belgium? That'd be three.
One from Brazil.
One from Brazil! Anybody here from Brazil? One.
And four from the UK.
And four from Great Britain. Anybody here from Great Britain?
Fantastic. So it's an international crew. I've seen you guys perform many times. You're here in the final. It doesn't get any bigger than this thing.
It definitely doesn't get any bigger than this at all. It's a great game to be at. Olympics is a great venue to be at as well. We're so happy to be here.
Fantastic. And of course, you know, you guys are going to go back to your individual countries as well. But what does it mean for you specifically as an American to watch your team perform right here in front of you guys and all the crowd?
It's great. It's great to see the team out here performing. The U.S., let's see if we can bring home a gold, and glad I got these guys out here jumping at the halftime.
Fantastic.
You know what, Nick? Listen, on behalf of all of the crowd that's seen you at the London 2012 Olympics, thank you very much indeed. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, let's hear it for the Get Tricky Skippers! Right, do not go anywhere, because I've just found out, Eddie, that we've got someone very, very special who's about to join us, all right? Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
And welcome back, everyone, to North Greenwich Arena. We've got a whale of a game here between the United States and Spain basketball men's gold medal game. 1 point differential at the half. The U.S. up 59-58 in one of the highest scoring finals ever at the Olympics. United States got off to a quick start, leading 35-27 after the first quarter. Spain outscored the U.S. 31-24. Great shooting from the outside from Spain as the U.S. got cold in the second quarter. Kevin Durant, 17 points for the U.S., but he was only 4 of 12 shooting from the field. For Spain, Juan Carlos Navarro, the four-time Olympian, 19 points. Rudy Fernandez, a dozen points. Pau Gasol, 8 points. But Steve Rebilliard, I think foul trouble may play into what we see here in the second half.
Yeah, if Pau Gasol is forced to limited minutes, Mark Gasol is forced to limited minutes in the second half, then that's going to limit their options, you know, if Ibaka's got to play more. But just looking at the Spain shooting, Bruce, and concerned that they've played two-thirds of their game in the first half, if I can put it that way. I don't think they can sustain it, regardless of the foul situation that they've got themselves in trouble with. They're shooting 46% from the field against the best team in the competition. Normally in the tournament they're shooting 45%, and I just wonder if they haven't overachieved in the first two quarters.
This is very similar to the silver and gold medal game in Beijing. Very similar flow. Spain right there. Now, how they ever lost a game to Russia and to Brazil, they obviously were not at this level for those games earlier, but Spain peaking at the right time. Kobe Bryant played very limited minutes for the U.S. in the first half. He hit 2 out of 3 three-pointers. You can get shot into a game with three-pointers and you can shoot yourself out, and that's what Kevin Durant seemed to do for the United States in the second quarter, missing 6 consecutive shots.
U.S. have got 8 from 18 with their three-pointers, but shot 7 of them in the first quarter.
And at one point, I believe they were 7 out of 8, so 1 out of the next 10, and that would have been Williams' shot. So Mike Krzyzewski, I'm sure, had some words about defense to his players, and Sergio Scariolo of Spain has to be very encouraged by the performances of his entire team. And he's got some journeymen that came in and hit some big shots. Sergio Yul, Felipe Reyes, Serge Ibaka, Sergio Rodriguez, all contributing here.
Olympic gold medalists are consistent with their performance across the event. Spain has got to concentrate, focus, bring the intensity to every second of every minute of every quarter. And they have not done that until now. And they're about to be asked that question again. The USA is good enough to be less than their most intense and keep pace with any team and then turn it on to win a game.
Here we go, second half. It's all on the line for the gold medal. I'm Bruce Breslow along with Steve Rebilliard. I hope you're enjoying this game. Spain can take the lead if they can score first. Spain in the red, U.S. in the white. Beautiful passing along the perimeter. Outside shot, no good. Ibaka comes up way short. Rebound Durant. That's not his shot. United States back with Chris Paul at point guard. That's LeBron James. They've got Durant, Tyson Chandler, and Kobe Bryant. That's the starting five from the beginning of the game. Chris Paul wide open for three.
Well, Ibaka's strengths and weaknesses are on display early, Bruce. You've got Marc Gasol off, like you were talking about.
Pau Gasol with the little hook shot. Got it. And quietly, Pau Gasol now with 10 points. Kobe Bryant, very streaky shooter. And kept alive by Chandler, who bats it out to LeBron James. 18 on the shot clock. Durant flies in, going for the slam, and he is challenged by Gasol. only one on POW. Durant made seven consecutive free throws to close out the first half. A brilliant young scorer, plays for the Oklahoma City Club in the NBA. Just 23 years old. U.S. lead up to four. Calderon, Fernandez, Gasol, on Tyson Chandler. Gasol to the basket again, draws the foul and scores the bucket. That's the one problem area for the United States center. They only have one, and that's Tyson Chandler. With Dwight Howard injured and Chris Bosh injured. So the only other large player they could bring in is a 19-year-old kid, Anthony Davis, out of the University of Kentucky, who was the NBA's number one draft pick. But they're not about to put him into a game like this at this time.
2 7-footers in the Spain team, the Gasol boys.
The lead is one again. James, little turnaround. And this crowd will go crazy if Spain takes the lead here.
And they do. The closer they can stay with the U.S., with Ibaka on instead of Marc Gasol, the chances just improve by the second.
8 seconds on the shot clock. Bryant working. The U.S. offense very stale looking as they start this second half. It's almost as if they don't want to shoot those three-pointers, and they're trying to get some passes, and they're not in a flow yet. Fernandez.
Well, Rudy Fernandez was looking open there for a while. They just couldn't see him, couldn't get it to him.
And because it was a click, a kick off the foot, they will reset the shot clock from 5 to 14 seconds. Navarro with a big first half. And that's Kevin Love. They brought him in to try to stop Gasol on the inside, give U.S. a little bit more rebounding. Plus, he can shoot from there. Ibaka with a nice rebound. One of the best defensive players in the world. Gasol on Love. That's his move. 17 for Pau Gasol, 9 in the quarter already. And we've only played 3.5 minutes. He's got all 9 of Spain's points. Spain by 3. A lot of one-on-one being played by this U.S. team. But when the one happens to be LeBron James, it's okay.
He's worth two. Spain leading the quarter, 9-7.
Ibaka. Gasol has it slapped away by Love. That was apparently clean, but they're going to whistle him quickly for a foul. Let's see. I'm not sure if we'll get another look at that. Does he foul him? He got a little of the hand, and then screaming and yelling and carrying on. It attracts the attention of the referee.
Well, I disagree. I think it was all ball, but that's right.
Third foul on Love, so the foul's adding up.
So if there's a fourth foul, there may not be a lot of love. Mr. Beckham is here. He was visiting a number of the events towards the end of the Olympics.
Powell knocks down the next one. He's got 18, and Spain still maintains the advantage. The tempo of this game is slowed significantly. Kobe Bryant blows by the defender, Jose Calderon.
I think he heard you.
Stolen away from behind by Paul. Gets it ahead to Durant. They're back on defense. Alley-oop James!
Durant to James. And that brings the crowd to their feet.
And that ties the game. Ibaka alley-oop down to Paul. Gasol. Got it.
Pow!
And action. Nice pass from Ibaka. Foul on Chris Paul, his third. And here's that perfect pass to LeBron James. So Gasol trying to complete a three-point play. 21 for Powell. And Spain back on top. Halfway through the third quarter, and this has been exactly the point in past games with the United States. Create some separation, usually through defense. Kobe Bryant for three.
Two from four from outside for the U.S. in this third quarter.
Navarro shot doesn't fall. They'll look for Kobe. Kobe will look for Kobe.
Barker had it stripped, but good backup from Navarro.
Calderon inside Gasol, and he throws it. And I thought he was going to shoot. He passed it. I wasn't expecting that. It's kind of like when Carmelo Anthony gets it inside. You don't really expect it to come back out. Foul number three on LeBron James. So for the United States, starting to get in some foul trouble. Anthony with three. Paul with three. Love with three. Williams with three. And James with three fouls. Ibaka with 5 points and eight rebounds in this game coming off the bench. Giving him some good minutes while Mark Gasol nurses those four fouls on the bench. Field goal percentages have dropped, both clubs close to 49%. Sergio Rodriguez back in for Spain, and Jose Calderon will sit. Calderon hasn't scored in this game, the three-time Olympian.
Ibaka's just a 50% free throw shooter. He's a guy worth targeting as far as the U.S. is concerned.
James. And Durant wide open. ...75-72, just under 4 minutes to go in the quarter. Stolen away. Bryant tries to dish off at the last second. He got caught in the air. And Kobe with an acrobatic move draws the foul. Second on Pau Gasol. There's Durant. Just enough room to get that shot off. For Bryant to the free throw line.
U.S. 16-14 lead the quarter.
Bryant's a 94% free throw shooter at the Olympic Games. and they're waiting to mop up the floor.
Which out of this U.S. team would you want at the line to shoot for you for the gold medal?
You're looking at him.
Kobe?
Kevin Love getting some attention from the trainer on the sideline. Got hit in the nose. .18 out of .21 from the line for the United States, 86%. 23 of 27 for Spain. Both of these teams spending a lot of time on the free throw line. It's what you would expect in a very physical game. Deron Williams comes in and Bryant will sit down. So it seems like every time Bryant gets hot, Krzyzewski's been taking him out. He's been playing limited minutes. Want to keep him fresh for the fourth quarter. Gasol gets it. Backing in. And Ibaka.
Well, Carmelo Anthony doing a lot of hard work in low, but it, Ibaka is too strong.
Well, the U.S. has no true center in the game. Closest thing they have right now to a center is LeBron James. And here we go for Spain, Sergio Rodriguez. U.S. careless with the basketball. Durant heating up.
Not so careless. Turnover and trouble.
And Paul gets a little nudge from Gasol and gets away with it. Gasol will slam it. So a change in fortune, and just like that, we've got a two-point game again. What a great gold medal game we're seeing.
We just went from third gear to fifth gear without engaging fourth.
And Spain is hanging in there. And more than hanging in there, Spain's about to tie it. Ibaka calls for the ball. Working on Anthony Ibaka. Air Congo. And we're tied at 80.
Ibaka's got 10.
Durant wants it. And you can see why. Minute and a half to go in this third quarter. The United States has made 8 of 14 in the quarter. Spain, 9 of 13. Excellent shooting, 70% in the quarter from Spain, and that's against a relentless U.S. defense. They are red hot.
Different story outside, though. 0 for 3, Spain, and 4 for 7, USA.
Rodriguez. And he posts up on Carmelo Anthony. That's American basketball right there. Chris Paul splits the defense, gets it to the hot shooter. And a foul on Ibaka. Serge with three now. Ibaka, also another great youngster, just 23 years of age. Pau Gasol is going to get a needed rest. Felipe Reyes will come in. He's a backup center, stands 205 or 6'9". Williams in, running the point for the United States. Anthony for three. Almost had a shot clock violation. With this many shooters on the court, that's a rarity in itself. 34 seconds left in the quarter. Rodriguez. Nice pass to Ibaka, and he is fouled hard going in for the shot. Looked like Serge wanted to dunk it.
Now Deron Williams. Just watching Carmelo Anthony in the key, he just looks a little lost at times defensively. He's not picking up anyone. could have assisted there, didn't move in.
That foul was actually on Andre Iguodala.
Thank you.
And Kobe Bryant is checked back in for the U.S., try to give him a little offense with 27 seconds left to go in the quarter. Ibaka back to the free throw line. He's been good from the line today. Made 6 of 8. So he was a 50% shooter coming in and an 80% shooter in the
going
game.
Out. 8 of 10.
He's got a dozen. Phenomenal job by Ibaka off the bench as Mark Gasol's replacement.
It's a 24-all quarter.
U.S. start of the quarter, leading by one. That's where we go. 10 seconds left. Williams. Williams tries to do it himself. 3 seconds left in the quarter. Shot at the buzzer, no good. So again, it's still a one-point game. A gold medal hanging out there. And this team tried to compare themselves to the original Dream Team of Magic Johnson, Larry Bird, Michael Jordan. Their legacy at stake here with Spain. 1 point behind as we head to the fourth quarter. Big third quarter for Pau Gasol. He came in with just 8 points and exits with 23.
Three quarters of the game gone, and a lot of the stats you're looking at, they're very even. And that can't be a surprise. U.S. dominant first quarter, 35-27. They won it by 8. Spain win the second quarter by 7. 24 all in the third. So you've just got a point separating gold and silver medalists. But who's to take which medal home?
Well, Juan Carlos Navarro scored 14 in the first quarter for Spain. Pau Gasol just scored 15 in the third quarter. And there's two of them. There's that nice pass to James. And Kobe Bryant's done an excellent job of shooting in limited minutes. Fans wanted an all-star showing, and they're getting it from both teams. And off the bench, Sergio Rodriguez has had some big buckets. Rodriguez with a nice feed to Gasol. That tied the game, got the crowd going, got the bench going.
I don't think too many of this crowd would have expected a one-point game at three-quarter time. The Spanish fans might have hoped for it, but the neutrals and American supporters would not have expected
this.
Well,
there's one person on the U.S. side that did expect it, and that's Coach Mike Krzyzewski. He knew they were going to bring a game at him. So you either have a legacy of being the best Dream Team, or for LeBron James, losing 2 gold medals in his career. All comes down to the fourth quarter. U.S. up by 1, and James starts it up.
Great pass from Kobe Bryant.
We're at the North Greenwich Arena playing for the gold medal. Down to the final quarter. Yule.
Oh, great fake to his left.
And Sergio Yule's only played about 2 minutes. He's got 5 points, has hit some key shots. We have no Gasols on the court for Spain. Chris Paul for 3. And he gets him run over, makes the shot, no foul. Carmelo Anthony with a strong rebound on that missed shot by Felipe Reyes. Paul goes right by his man for 2. Chris Paul. Paul's 27 years old in his second Olympics, 5-time NBA All-Star. He's been playing with a strained hamstring most of the year. United States trying to turn it up defensively, and they get another steal, and we've got incidental contact.
Rudy Fernandez trying to disguise it as incidental.
He tried to get out of the way, but there was nowhere to go. And Carmelo Anthony doing a little jawing with Rudy Fernandez, too.
Seven-two start to the quarter for the U.S.
And Spain's going to call a timeout, and they're going to bring Pau Gasol back in. And the referee trying to get in the middle, make sure that, you know, this is a very heated contest here. The two teams going back and forth at each other. We've got a quick timeout. The U.S. up by six now, 90-84.
I'm surprised to hear you defend the defense in that clash there, Brizzy. He looked like he stepped into the line to me, but yeah, out comes the Etch-a-Sketch.
They're setting up a three-point shot. So who's going to end up with the hot hand here? You've watched these streaky scores, whether it be Gasol or Ibaka or Navarro. For the U.S., you've seen Durant and Kobe Bryant. Carmelo Anthony's been rather quiet since he hit a couple three-pointers early in this game. LeBron James can take over a game, too.
I don't think they have to get hot from the outside. All they have to do is step up the defensive intensity, which they've shown again and again right through the tournament that they can do, and they just put the opposition on starvation rations for points.
Quick 5 points for Chris Paul. Paul traded this past year to the LA Clippers. LeBron James, 8:14 left to play. And Ibaka, another rebound. In past years, if Gasol had been in foul trouble, that would have been a big blow to Spain, but they've added Ibaka, this team. Kobe Bryant, known more for his scoring than his defense, but a great defender, is on the court again for the U.S.
Shot clock pressure forced the attempt.
Paul blows by his first man and throws it away. He had James a little bit too hard.
So Lithuania got within five of the U.S. You rank Spain.
Well, that game was tied with 2 minutes to go. So Spain, yes, every indication is that they have the weapons and they have the tools. They certainly have the heart and desire. It'll be a matter of which club plays better defense. And Gasol, incidental contact, got hit right in the eye.
Define incidental, Bruce.
Well, accidental. How about that? It's okay. Not a Three Stooges move where you poke somebody in the eye. You'll see right here.
Well, he was reaching for an area where the ball was not.
But that was not a Larry Moen curly moment. But that's a big one. And the trainer working on Gasol under the basket. Four fouls on LeBron James. Gasol looks no worse for wear. And Mark Gasol comes back into the lineup. He's got four fouls. There's Navarro. Quickly takes the shot. And Durant with another rebound. Been a while since Durant took a shot. He cooled off a bit.
3 minutes into the last quarter, Spain have not had a three-pointer since the second quarter.
Paul really pressuring the basketball. Navarro trying to go inside. Mark Gasol working on Love. Nice shot coming off the bench. Quickly, 2 points. Mark Gasol. Little brother, just 27. Bryant's shot won't go. Kept alive by Carmelo Anthony and Love. Kevin Durant, 30 points now. 7-point difference.
Durant just turned away as though he'd just done the easiest thing in the world.
Paul with a good steal from behind, and Spain has to foul because the U.S. had an easy two coming down on the break. You saw the steal and then the reach-in foul. I think that's Rudy Fernandez. And Spain's going to call a timeout as the game in danger of being broken open a bit. The U.S. with a 7-point lead, 93-86. So, Steve, we thought it would come down to defense at the end. It's a 10-4 quarter so far. How does Spain answer?
Well, you just go back to what they did well in the second quarter, and they've got timid from outside. Whether they're being shut down out there by a better defense in the third and now fourth quarter, you know, they've got to get some easy points.
Coach Scariolo outlining a play, and that's as close as we're going to get to hear what Mike Krzyzewski has to say. Coach K, widely respected as the most outstanding coach that America has. That's high school, college, and NBA. A lot of international journalists have asked me why they didn't choose an NBA coach. There's nobody in the U.S. better than Coach K.
Why isn't he coaching an NBA team then?
Because he's got a better job at Duke. He's been there forever.
He likes developing players?
He loves to teach. And in the NBA, there's, you know, you face it. You've got a team full of millionaires that have already proven themselves. It's not the same. You get 4 years to train a player, make them better, stay with the university.
He's been offered NBA contracts?
They never talk about that.
Okay. Well, we won't.
Kobe Bryant for three. Fouled, scored the bucket. That's huge. Reaching foul on Rudy Fernandez, and Kobe Bryant, a huge basket for the United States. Just when Spain could not afford the United States to score again.
You talk about the athleticism and power of the U.S. players. They can ride these bumps, still get the shot away effectively, and they get bonus points.
Bryant misses the free throw. They did not give him the basket. They wiped out the three-pointer. And get one more. So two out of three for Kobe. Admittedly named after the steak. His father, Jellybean Bryant, played a lot in Italy. Kobe speaks fluent Italian when was a child. Learned to play basketball in Italy.
The U.S. by nine, inside 6 minutes to go.
Fourth foul on Kevin Love, so the U.S. running low on big men. A lot of players playing in this game with four fouls.
Seen worse than that, not draw a whistle.
Gasol. And Love with a rebound. Carmelo Anthony left open, in and out. Juan Carlos Navarro now. He's been silent for a long time offensively. And credit Chris Paul for a lot of that. And the give and go to Gasol and a whistle.
Spain has not put up a three-point attempt in this last quarter.
That little bump from Anthony. And I think that's four on Carmelo Anthony as well.
Threes give you such momentum and confidence that if, at least try, you know, pull the trigger from out there, see what happens. Someone who feels like they've got a hot hand or someone who's going to step up and take control. If not control, then at least give the U.S. something to think about.
This game is still up for grabs with just over 5 minutes left to play, 95-87. Kobe Bryant crossed the way. Chris Paul decides not to shoot, and Bryant said, give it back to me then. Gasol with a good rebound. Anthony almost had his fifth foul. Sergio Llull back in for Spain. He's number 12. Mark Gasol, turn around.
They all need to go as the seconds tick by for Spain.
Been very impressed with the rebounding of Kevin Durant in this game. Anthony will shoot again. And Bryant, offensive rebound, puts it back in for the USA. Kobe Bryant had six in the first half, now 17, and back comes Spain. They answer just when you wanted a three-pointer.
It's only two.
I know, but you wanted a three. '97-89 our score. 4 minutes to play. Chris Paul sets the tempo for the U.S. Eight seconds on the shot clock. Look for Kobe Bryant to go to work here. And he got stuck up in the air. Poor play by Kobe. Spain comes down. Navarro tipped back in. Rudy Fernandez's first basket of the second half. Couldn't have come at a better time. And Carmelo Anthony throws it out of bounds. Kobe Bryant was there for a minute. Anthony missed him. So the United States wants a timeout. 97-91, six-point game, 3:20 left to play. And Pau Gasol got in Bryant's way, kept him from attempting that shot, and then came down and followed. Great game, Steve, by Pau Gasol.
I don't think it matters, you know, about the reputations of NBA players turning up for the USA today. If you're not nervous in the last quarter, in the last minutes of a gold medal game at the Olympics, then, you know, you're not human. And I'm just seeing a couple of errors from USA in defense and offense to suggest that they're tightening up just a little bit, and Spain has to prize open the door a little further.
Taking a look at the numbers, Gasol with those 24 points also has 8 rebounds and 7 assists. Navarro 21 points on 7 of 16 shooting. For the U.S., Kevin Durant's their leading scorer with 30. He's made 8 of 18, 5 of 13 from 3-point, so he's actually shooting better behind the arc than he is inside of it. Kobe Bryant with 17 points. And Kevin Love in 11 minutes has 9 points and 9 rebounds for the United States. So statistically, that should catch you up. The only numbers that really matter, 3 minutes, 20 seconds left on the clock. It was a 1-point game at the half. It was a 1-point game at the end of 3 quarters. Spain down by 6, looking to cut it further. That's Yule.
Well, Fernandez did it. Good job keeping Durant away from it. I can just come back to my favorite stat, though, here, Bruce. It's the 17 minutes since Spain have drained a three.
Just over 3 minutes left in the game. They're going to the hot hand. The U.S. controls, and a reach-in foul.
Sergio Rule. So Yule will tie up Chris Paul. And amazingly, the team's not in a bonus situation. This is the only quarter where they didn't have that many fouls in the beginning. LeBron James, the U.S. looking for a basket. LeBron James got a lane. LeBron James. And the defense went to sleep on that play. That's like a punch in the stomach to Spain.
Yeah, eight the difference. 2:35 left. Spain in the gold medal game for a third time. Are they going to be beaten by for a third time by the U.S.? Odds shortening by the second. Kirilenko.
Kirilenko had 20 in the bronze medal match. There's a look at James going in for that. Kobe Bryant called for that last foul. Navarro. Goes by James. Love, good helping defense, but nothing you could do with that great pass to Mark Gasol.
Okay, Spain need a stop here.
Great ball movement. 6-point differential. Plenty of time to go. James backs up. 6 seconds on the shot clock. This is going to be James.
Cometh the hour. Cometh the man, LeBron.
And an offensive blocking foul called on Pau Gasol, and that was great defense being played by Chris Paul. Gasol pleading his case like the referee's going to actually change his mind. You see him right here. He's moving. And if he had stayed still that whole time, he would have been fine. That's a key turnover. United States is going to call a timeout. They lead with just 1:52 left to play, 102-93.
What I loved about these Olympics, Bruce, is that, you know, people have turned up events brave enough to wear the stupidest things and create a great atmosphere. And, you know, the volunteers have got a sense of humor. And we're getting very close to the end of this two-week every four-year party. Spain have played a big part in this match, but the hole is deep enough for them not to get out of, I think.
Well, that LeBron James, when he saw the lane and took it down and dunked it in and then came back and hit that last shot, that really takes the wind out of the sails of Spain. James, 19 points. And there it is, the defense turning their back on him. Never do that. And then with the shot clock winding down, you got the hot hand, you got the feel, take it yourself.
19-11, the last quarter to the U.S. They're doing as they've done all tournament, dominating in the last 10 minutes.
Spain not out of it. 1:45 left to play for the gold medal. Chris Paul, U.S. going to use some of the shot clock. James calling for the ball. They will clear out and let LeBron James do his thing. Spain looking for a double team. He takes the three-pointer and just an air ball. And Kobe Bryant with a very smart play kept it alive, but the shot clock was winding down. And James couldn't get that one to fall, but they used a lot of clock.
Margin 4 years ago, 11, 118 to 107 in Beijing.
Yule gives him a little bit better outside shot at point guard. Navarro for three. And that may do it. 102-93, 110 left to play. Spain can only foul here, and they're not going to do it. Using all of the shot clock is Chris Paul.
And at the buzzer, Chris Paul with a marvelous spin move to the hoop.
Well, they're not feeling the pressure now. They're playing just the right basketball to finish the deal here.
Pau Gasol on Love. And slapped away by Durant. And Durant's played a very good game rebounding it on defense to go with those 30 points. He'll have the medal ceremonies when this game is over. Nice cut to the basket. Mark Gasol for a quick two. And a quick reach-in foul. So the clock running out on Spain's chances. Rudy Fernandez gets a big hand as he goes to the bench. Fouls out with 14 points. Also going to the bench, Navarro, and he gets a very warm welcome from this crowd. The 32-year-old captain in his fourth Olympics. And they're all standing for both teams. 37 seconds left to play. The United States substituting out. Love comes out of the game. Kobe Bryant comes out of the game. LeBron James, Bryant gets a hug from his coach, and Mike Krzyzewski is going to coach the USA to two gold medals in a row.
And it will be Olympic championship number 14 for the U.S. since 1936.
We may not see some of these players come back for another. Juan Carlos Navarro at 32 years of age. Pau Gasol already 32. But you never know. Seconds left to the gold medal. Mark Gasol fouled on his way to the basket. It counts, and it'll give him a chance at a three-point play. A little bit too late, though.
They've already hugs all around on the bench for the U.S. They've already known for some seconds now that the gold medal is safe. Kobe Bryant, a smile of satisfaction.
So hampered by those four fouls, Mark Gasol didn't play a lot, but he scored 15 points. Just a matter of what the final number will be. Iguodala in. And quickly, Spain fouls James Harden.
Well, not too many teams beat the United States at the Olympics, and Spain never. This will be loss number 11 against their nemesis.
But they have lost with their so-called dream team lineup. That was just in Athens. Great game from Pau Gasol. Harden, an all-star in the NBA, used very sparingly here. And Coach K is very honest with the players. They have to have some players that be there on the bench.
Just looking around the room, Bruce, everyone's on their feet. It's just a great moment coming up. The end of the gold medal basketball game comes to its expected conclusion.
Yule to Gasol. Making it a little closer here at the end. 13 seconds left. And Harden will go back to the free throw line again. 12.1. Technically not over. Two possession game if he should miss.
Yeah, that would be embarrassing. All the celebration we've been watching on the U.S. bench if it all went pear-shaped from here. It's hard to envisage, but not impossible.
Well, Harden can put it away here. Needs this to make it a three-possession game. Sergio Scariolo still coaching on the sideline. Has not given up yet. Never thought this would be a crucial free throw in the game. And that'll do it. Ewell will launch. And the rebound to the 19-year-old Anthony Davis, and the United States will win the gold medal. And a heck of an effort by Spain today, Steve.
They brought their best game to the gold medal match, but it wasn't enough. United States just retreated in that second quarter when Spain outscored them 31-24. But they stepped it up in the last, as they always do.
U.S. coach Krzyzewski went right to Pau Gasol, tell him what respect he has for him. And you see Kobe Bryant, their teammates with the Lakers. A lot of admiration for the effort and the hustle of Pau Gasol by his own teammates.
You know, you see a lot of respect before the match, you see it after, and there's no quarter asked or given.
Gasol, 24 points, 8 rebounds, 7 assists. Juan Carlos Navarro, perhaps his last ever game as the U.S. celebrates, had 21 points.
Well, the crowd's been richly entertained at North Greenwich Arena.
I got, you know, for as talented as they are not very good dancers, are they? For the United States, Kevin Durant, a huge night, 30 points, 9 rebounds. LeBron James had his points when it mattered most, 19. Kobe Bryant, 17. Chris Paul had 11 points. The United States is going to win another gold medal, but not before they're given a huge battle by Spain. It stretched them to the limit. And the final moments in between the huddle for Spain and a very happy Kobe Bryant, the face of the NBA all across this land. The fans certainly got their money's worth, didn't they?
83-82 at three-quarter time. It's a wonderful achievement from Spain to reach the gold medal game, push this extraordinary team all the way. And only 7 the margin, so that's as close as they've come in the 3 gold medal appearances together.
So the teams will leave the court, and they'll come back in just a little while for the medal ceremony. We hope you can stay with us. We're going to take a break. Once again, the final score of this one, a great game. The United States beating Spain 107-100. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to North Greenwich Arena for the victory ceremony of men's basketball. I'm Bruce Breslow. Alongside me is Steve Rebilliard. And Steve, we got more of a game than a lot of people thought.
Certainly did. I can't give enough tribute to Spain, and I think we saw the respect offered by the U.S. team at the end of the match. They knew they'd been asked a lot of questions. They were able to answer them by the end of the match. But they had to fight appropriately hard to win the gold medal. And Spain hadn't, until the gold medal game, scored 100 points here.
Here comes the bronze medal winner. Russia with an 81-77 hard-fought win earlier today.
I love their match.
Not many people thought that Russia could beat Argentina, but they did.
They wanted it more.
The United States now. You know, there was a fine line in this game when it was a one-point game. And you think about legacy when they're talking about whether this is the greatest team ever assembled. Had they lost, Carmelo Anthony, LeBron James would have lost two gold medals during their time. So that fourth quarter when LeBron James took over a little bit of the game, that really helped get the U.S. fired up. And that means so much to him and USA basketball. And then for Spain, so close. Two Olympics in a row.
It's of no consolation at this point that they weren't expected to win, and that people think a lot of them for playing as well as they did. That in time, they'll look back with great pride.
This USA basketball team treated like rock stars. You know, when they come into London, everybody follows them around, tries to get close to them to take a picture. It's almost like they're stalking the royal family. IOC member from the Philippines. IOC member Philip Craven. Sir Philip. Patrick Baumann from Switzerland. FIBA's changed some of the rules to make this more in line with the NBA, the 24-second shot clock. The key isn't in a funny-looking shape anymore.
I like the L shape.
One thing I like more about international basketball is the rule about when the ball hits the rim, you're allowed to go get it, knock it in or knock it out. We're just about ready to get started here. And the medals. Bronze going to Russia. They were not expected. Ranked 11th coming in here. Alexei Shved, number 4. He'll be going to the Minnesota Timberwolves. Just signed a new contract. He and his teammate Andrei Kirilenko, who combined for 45 points in that bronze medal match. This is Alexei Shved. Timothy Mozgov plays for the Denver Nuggets, getting his medal. Sergei Karasov now. This is Vitali Friedzin. Good outside shooter, had 19 points in the bronze medal game. Big Sasha Khan, the starting center. Victor Kuryapa taking a video of himself getting the medal. Semen Antonov. This is Sergei Manya, the captain of the team. little used Dmitry Kovalstov. And this is Anton Pokrashov, who is the starting point guard for Russia. And Andrei Kirilenko. There's Pokrashov, and Kirilenko will be next. 31 years old, has played in a bunch of Olympics, great score. AK-47, the Russian rifle. 20 points in the bronze medal match. And a good hand for the team from Russia, coached by an American, David Blatt. You know, people associate the game with America, but it was founded by a Canadian, Dr. James Nesmith, who brought the game to the United States, hanging up peach baskets on the YMCA wall.
And now, of course, it's been in the Olympic program for such a long time. It's so identifiable as an Olympic sport. We might see a lot more of NBA basketball and European basketball.
Now, this game has been played even outdoors at the Olympics. I like this way better. Russia, probably the most stylish team out there. They always seem to go wild with their Olympic decor.
You cannot miss them. Supporters of Russia and Russian athletes, the track suits are something else.
And hands off again. And David Blatt, the coach is not up there getting medals, but certainly the coach is a big part of this. And there's the bronze medal winners, the Russian Federation.
David Blatt had an enormous hand to play in the last couple of minutes of that match when it was absolutely on the line. He made some crucial calls that came off.
And now España's turn, coached by Sergio Scariolo. And they will walk the medals down. Spain once again will be wearing silver. 2 meters 15, 7 foot one, Los Angeles Lakers standout Pau Gasol gets his silver medal. Rudy Fernandez had 14 points in that game, including that one dunk that woke everybody up. Let them know they were there. Sergio Rodriguez came off the bench for 7 in the gold medal game. The great one, La Bamba, Juan Carlos Navarro, overcame severe back injury, rehabilitated, came back for the last 3 games here. 21 points on the final. Jose Calderon, oddly scoreless in his third Olympics. Felipe Reyes now. This is Victor Claver. Did not get into this final game. New member of the Portland Trailblazers. Fernando San Emeterio also did not play. This little guy came off the bench, hit a couple clutch baskets. Sergio Llull, spelled L-L-U-L-L. Mark Gasol, hampered in foul trouble, still scored 17 points. Plays with the Memphis Grizzlies of the NBA, just 27 years old. Air Congo, Serge Ibaka, very happy 23-year-old, gets to play in the Olympics with Spain. 12 points in the game, and Victor Seda. And that's the members of your silver medalists.
I think the difference or the point of change comes from disappointment of winning a silver medal or coming second. It turns around once it's on your neck, and then you've got this thing to look at and say, hey, this is special, and I'm proud now. Come up just a little short against the United States.
Could have used Ricky Rubio, their great young point guard who injured himself severely during the NBA season. He's still rehabilitating. But keep in mind, the U.S. team without Dwayne Wade, Dwight Howard, Chris Bosh, Derrick Rose, all selected to be part of the team due to injuries that they had. And the bouquets. You ever had a bouquet?
Yes, wedding day, but I had to give it to my wife. Some years ago.
There you have your silver medal winners, Spain, España. And now, ladies and gentlemen, from the United States of America, and they lock arms. Olympic Games champion, 107 to 100, the final score. The center, 2 meters, 16, 7 foot one from the New York Knicks, Tyson Chandler gets the first gold medal. Kevin Durant, what a game he had. A bunch of rebounds, some good passing. 30 points. Kevin Durant, only 23 years old. LeBron, the king, King James, comes through big when the game matters the most. This is Russell Westbrook. Plays for Oklahoma City, one of three on this team from Oklahoma City. What a great young team they have. Deron Williams, the first member of the Brooklyn Nets to win a gold medal. They will move the team to Brooklyn. Andre Iguodala, traded recently from Philly to Denver. In fact, during halftime of the last game, there's Kobe Bryant. Has five NBA titles and a couple gold medals. Kevin Love. James Harden, easy to spot in the crowd. Chris Paul came in, scored 8 of his 11 points in the second half, and that quick surge he gave them really helped. The youngest player, 19-year-old Anthony Davis, pressed into action due to those injuries. He will play in New Orleans. And finally, Carmelo Anthony. You called him an enigma, Steve. The gold medal winning team from the United States. Thirteen gold medals and 16 Olympic opportunities. So who won the other gold medal, Steve?
Well, we had two for the Soviet Union, one for Argentina 8 years ago.
And the next one's the stumper.
That is, except in 1980, when the U.S. wasn't there, and you might logically think that was a year that the Soviet Union won, they did not. And the winners were Yugoslavia. So that might be a question to ask your friends next time you gather around testing each other's sports trivia knowledge. But a daunting record the U.S. now holds in Olympic basketball.
There's been some discussion of whether the NBA would limit play in the future to players 23 years and younger, but we haven't heard anything that would make us think that they would go forward with that at this time. Playing in the Olympics, it's such a showcase for the league with this talent and these players. It really would be a shame to restrict them.
I wouldn't like to see that. You know, there's talk of that at Winter Olympic level with ice hockey as well, the availability of the top players.
But it certainly forced the rest of the world to get better in a hurry. These players, ambassadors all around the world when they're not playing. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the national anthem of the gold medal winning team from the United States of America. Are they the greatest team ever assembled? I'm not going to go there. I was there in Barcelona with you.
I go back to your earlier point that you made. I don't see much value in comparing teams across eras when the level of professionalism has even, you know, is changes over a couple of decades. You know?
If 11 of these players go on to become members of the NBA Hall of Fame like the original team, at that point I can look back and try to make a comparison. United States getting all they could handle from Spain today, winning the gold medal in Olympic fashion, 107-100.
You got your answer today about why the NBA players should be here at the Olympics, and what is the point of having your sport in the Olympics if you don't have the best players, the best athletes in the world attend?
And it's not all about the American NBA players.
No.
All of the Spanish players have played in the NBA as well, the starters, and many of others, and three of the Russians are going too. So as the players celebrate in midcourt and pose for photos, I want to say thank you very much. It's an honor. This is my eighth Olympics. I've had the opportunity, and I've been working with you for a while. Steve Rebilliard, I'm Bruce Breslow. Thank you so much for listening, and we hope you have a wonderful night.
Yep. Look after yourselves, and we hope you've enjoyed the journey with us, and all the best.
Tonight's gonna be a good night. Welcome to Hadley Farm in Essex, one of the most stunning venues of the London 2012 Games. We've got beautiful weather here again and a full house for the men's cross-country mountain biking. Weather is perfect, that temperature rising all of the time. 16 kilometres or 10 mile an hour wind coming off the Thames estuary. Just cooling things down nicely here. Sat next to me in the commentary box is Olympic gold medalist and our legend, Mr. Chris Boardman. Chris, mountain bike competitions don't get much better than this in terms of venue and weather, do they?
No, they don't. And I'm not quite sure where they got that 18 degrees from, but I'd say it feels an awful lot hotter than that sitting here in the commentary box. It's going to be a factor, I think, in this race. The breeze is welcome because it is off the estuary and it is it's helping quite a lot. In fact, it's an unusual course for mountain biking. We talked a little bit about it yesterday in the women's race, but it's very, very open, not many trees at all, and that is making for some spectacular viewing. You can see virtually 70% of this course that's been outlined for you now from a single vantage point, and it has been spectacular for the spectators.
Well, this course is 4.7 kilometers long and it's full of short climbs, a lot of real bursts of energy. You've just come through the feed zone and the technical zone, then you've got Dean's Drop, very technical section, loops you back. Other sections include the Breathtaker, the Triple Trouble. You can see the elevation profile there, 172 meters of climb per lap. So the men doing seven laps will do about 1,200 meters of climbing. And a lot of people saying it's going to be a very fast start today.
I think you put that into context. I mean, you think about that, over 3,500 feet of climbing in just 1.5 hours of racing. And when they're not going uphill, they're going down over some really treacherous technical sections.
So the field are lining up at the start line. Three big names that we're looking at today. Reigning Olympic champion, Julian Absalon. We've got Nino Schurter, this year the 2012 world champion, and then Jaroslav Kulhavy from the Czech Republic, the 2011 world champion, and all of them very, very close in ability, and a lot of people saying it's going to be incredibly tight.
Well, I've been speaking to members of the British team and seeing what do they think, and the jury really seems to be out. It is, if not a wide open race, then there's certainly about 10 people who could take this title. Absalon, well, four times world champion, he could make it three gold medals in a row if he won here. He's been very beatable in the intervening 4 years, but he won the test event a year ago, and for me, I think that experience just might shine through.
He said he was so young, he was 23 years old, same age as Bresset, who we saw win yesterday when he won his first medal, and then he had all that pressure heaped on him in Beijing. He's coming here very, very relaxed.
Well, we're about to see them head into the start, and I think this is a really important part of the race. See, Britain's Liam Killeen, he's on the fourth row, I think it is, close enough to the front. We're going to go around a loop, a start loop, which helps to just thin this 50-man field out a little bit before they go straight up a climb and onto the first technical section. And I think that first technical section, there's going to be so many people on it, well, there'll almost certainly be some crashes there. So really important, this first couple of minutes of racing. Commentators giving us 15 seconds to go now. See the riders already putting pressure on the pedal, just waiting to get away, and they're off.
And a very good start for Schurter, and then Vogel just behind him, both of the Swiss.